In this video, we're going to create a time control system inspired by games like RimWorld, where this is going to allow us to play at normal speed, fast speed, or in ultra fast speed. I'm already starting this with a basic character setup, so I'm going to be using a level like this with our character here, and we're going to just go in and start adding in the time management stuff. So all I really have here is a main node with our tile map, our player, and then we're going to really be working in this time display and time label. So I'm going to be using the time label to show visually how much quicker time is going and which phase of speed that we're in. So whether we're in normal, fast, paused. So in order to get working on this, we're going to need to first create a script that is going to be an autoload. So let's create this script. We're going to call it our time manager. And before we forget, let's just go into our project settings. And we're going to go to our globals and let's go find this time manager and let's add it as a global. In this script, we're going to have an enum and a constant. The enum is going to be for our speed. We're going to have paused for 0. Normal is 1. Fast is 2. And ultra is 3. These are going to correspond to what keys we press to generate which speed we're going to want our time to move at. And we're also going to have a constant, which is going to be a speed multiplier. And this is going to be our speed.paused. Let's actually just make this properly formatted here. So speed.paused is going to be 0. We're going to have speed.normal 1. Speed.fast is going to be 2, and speed.ultra will be 3. We're going to have two signals. One is going to be time changed, and it gives hours in an int and minutes of an int, and signal speed changed, and we give it a new speed of the type speed. We're going to have two variables of our current speed. And we're going to default this to speed normal. And then we're going to have a game time, which is a float, and it's going to equal 0. And this game time is going to be our time in minutes. So let's build out our process method. And in order to do that, we're going to need two other methods, which we will come back to. But let's just get these set up. So we're going to have a set speed. We're going to get a new speed, which equals our speed, and it's not going to return anything. And then we are going to have a get game speed, which is going to return a string, and we will pass. So in our process, we're going to look if our current speed doesn't equal to speed.paused. Then we're going to update the game time. So we're going to go game time plus equals delta times 60. Times our speed multiplier at the index of our current speed. Then we're going to get a variable called hours, and we're going to set this equal to game time divided by 60 as an integer, and then mod 24. And we're going to get our minutes, which is our game time as an integer, mod 60. And then we can emit our time change signal. We give it our hours and minutes. Inside of our set speed, all we're going to do is current speed equal to our new speed that we're passing in. And then we can emit this signal. And then in our get game speed, all we're doing is return speed.keys. And then we give it the current speed. Then just to demonstrate this, we are going to build out the UI here. So we're going to click on this time display canvas layer. And we're going to attach a script. We're going to drag an onReady for our time label. In our ready method, we're going to tap in to the two signals that we made in our time manager. So we're going to tap into time changed, connect, and on time changed. Then we're going to do time manager dot speed changed dot connect on speed changed. So let's make those methods right now. And on time changed is going to get two variables passed in. It's going to be our hours and our minutes, both of which are going to be integers. And then all we're going to do here is get our time label dot text. We're going to set it equal to a format string. So it's going to be like this to properly display our time. We give it the percent sign, and then we pass in what we want to fill out. So we're going to do our hours, minutes, and our time manager. Then we want to get our game speed. Then we need to make our on speed changed. So let's do that. We are going to get passed in a new speed, which is a type of time manager.speed. I'm not going to return anything here. And we're going to get our time label. I'm going to modulate. It's going to be equal to color.white. And we're going to create a tween. Then we're going to do tween property on our time label. Modulate color 111.0.7, 0.1. And then we're going to just copy this line since we're going to take some of this. And all we're going to do, not going to need this here, but we will just do a color.white 0.1. So in here, we're just going to flash the label when the speed changes. And then in our input, we're going to use the space bar to toggle pause. So if our event.isActionPressed, UI accept, we need to do an if else. So we're going to, if our time manager dot current speed equals time manager dot speed dot paused, we're going to reset to our normal speed. So we're going to set our speed back to our time manager dot speed normal. Otherwise, we need to pause. So we'll do our time manager set speed, and we're going to change this to paused. And I'm going to use number keys to correspond to each of these speeds too. So we set those up in our time manager. So we're going to do an if event is pressed and event is input event key. I'm going to match our event dot key code. So then if we have our key 0, we are going to get our time manager, and we're going to set the speed, the time manager dot speed dot paused. And we need to do the rest of these for 1, 2, and 3. So I'm just going to copy and paste these real quick. I'm going to do 1, 2, and 3. So 1 will be normal, 2 will be fast, and 3 will be ultra. So in order to have this work with our character as well, I do need to go to my player script, and I need to add a couple of lines into our velocity calculations. So right now I'm just multiplying direction times speed, but I also need to multiply our time manager, get the speed multiplier, and then we're going to do our time manager and get the current speed. I'm actually going to copy this as well, because we will also need to do this on our animation player. And we want to do the speed scale. So we want our animations to speed up just like our movement would, or otherwise it's going to look a little bit off. So now we're going to just equal to that, not multiply though, just going to be equal. And then in our else, we need to do the same thing as well. Okay, and now we're ready to test this out. So here we have normal. This is how my character moves. When I hit space, we pause. I can't do anything. When I hit 2, I'm at fast. My guy's moving a little bit faster. And now when I go to 3, we're on ultra. And there you go. A quick time management or time control system, similar to what you could see in RimWorld or other games like that. Let me know in the comments if you want me to remake some game mechanics from some other games.